Hi ladies and gents, Pond here with another video for Rise of Empires Ice and Fire. Today it's Tuesday building day and we're back on the road to C25. First off, thank you so much for all your previous likes, comments and subscriptions. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, why not click on that subscribe and ring the bell so you can get notifications of whenever I'm dropping videos on the channel, which is daily. And now back to the road to C25 castle. So we have currently at C21 and I'm pleased to say that today we are going to be upgrading to C22. Now, first off, just to look at where we've got to in terms of being able to upgrade. So with our storages, I have the lumber storage free building at level 1. I have upgraded my iron storage to iron storage level 2. That leaves me 500,000 lower than the requirement for this upgrade, but that's fine. I'm just going to bridge that gap with using some gems because the next upgrade would have cost 43 million lumber, which is quite a considerable amount. It's costing 28 million lumber for this upgrade. I do have enough lumber, but just, you know, if you want to upgrade quicker, then, you know, you can get away with using those gems to bridge the gaps in your storage sometimes. With my food storage, I've also unlocked food storage 3 level 1, so that is giving me 36.5 million food storage capacity. I've upgraded my marble to, I've finished marble storage 2, so that's at level 10, and that's given me 57.5 million capacity. That's important because you need 57 million for the C22 upgrade. The marble level 3 building is waiting to be built. That's another 16 million lumber and a bit of iron, so I've held off upgrading that for now. I'm going to do that once we've done this upgrade. Now, looking at the upgrade requirements, so if you remember from when we actually upgraded to C21, you do have to hit 210,000 population, and you can see that I've upgraded all of my houses to level 21, and that's given me 221,000 total population, so you don't quite have to do all of the houses to be able to hit that requirement. 21 million gold, the 28 million food and lumber, as I said, 2.5 million charcoal, and then the 57 million lumber and 42 million iron. So with it all done, you can see that the building time is 7 days, 2 hours. So with the 500,000 shortfall of the iron and the building time, it's gonna cost me 17,470 gems. That's fine, I've got 57,000 in the account. I have spent about 40,000 gems on gathering gear this week, trying to get more gathering material so that that can improve my gathering efficiency. If you're wondering, it's taken me 2 weeks to get from C21 up to this C22 upgrade, and I've been able to do it quickly because I have started raiding my main farms. So you can see the road to C25 castle is just above Pond Farm 3 here. Pond Farm 3 is a C25, it's generating a lot of resources for me, so I have been raiding that daily, and that's why I've been able to generate so many resources. I'm actually not able to maximize, I can't actually get out any more than I have been. I've been using my class legion and my legion 1. It's not really worth trying to raid with the other two legions just because their troop capacity is so low at this point. But let's get this upgrade going then, guys. So it is building day. I've activated my 100% bonus and I did some upgrades. I finished some previous upgrades on the previous hour to get points for the C22 upgrade. It's going to increase our power by, 4,700. So that's a nice upgrade. I'll probably need to then, what I will immediately do is the marble upgrade, and that will get me the third rewards chest for this hour so I can maximize my benefits. So let's get the upgrade done. Here we go, and at C22, it does give you the option to change your class. So you can change your class every 3 levels at 16, 19, 22, and 25. This account is purely me showing the different upgrade levels in the game from C1 to C25. So for me, it's all about generating as many resources as I can, as quickly as I can. So I'm going to keep, I could go to Raider actually, because I can raid my farms. I will do this. So ideally, if you're if you're upgrading your main accounts, when you get to C22, you probably do want to switch to Raider. Maybe when you're at C19, you might even want to switch to Trader, because then you can start building up your gold resources through that way. But and also unlock the market. Being Raider after C22, obviously you're probably going to be a stronger account. You're going to be playing more KE at the weekends. You want to obviously generate gold. So if you're hitting enemy castles, that's going to, when you're a Raider, your class legion can raid gold. So that's a good way of generating it. And obviously being a Raider, you can actually take more resources. So I am going to switch to Raider now, which is what I would have done on, which is what I did do on my main account. So let's do this class change. I've got troops on National Quest, so I'll have to do that later. So I will, after once my troops have come back from National Quest, I will change over to Raider. Of course, when you change your class, then your class manual points get reset. So I am an agricultural scholar at level 79, but this is actually going to reset my level when you become a Raider. So you have to build up your levels all over again. These points do not transfer. Some people have asked me that before. Let's get the upgrade reward. So, yeah, 4.35 million gold, not a lot of resources. Let's check what the upgrade requirements are for C23. Now, C23, for those of you that are working on your main accounts, I would say it is worth pushing through and rushing up to C23 as quickly as you can. And the reason for that is that in the daily Clash of Province rewards at C23 and C24, you get 2 super recruitment tickets each day if your state wins the Clash of Province that day. So for those of you that are free to play players, this is going to be, along with completing zone commemoration, which doubles your rewards so that you get the third, you get 2 super recruitment tickets on your third rewards chest in the Clash of Province rewards every day. If you can get up to C23 as quickly as possible, that's another 2 tickets if your state is winning Clash of Province, and that will allow you to accumulate super tickets much quicker. So definitely focus on upgrading, focus on getting your castle to C23 and finishing your zone commemoration research. Those are 2 really key things. So to get the next level, level 23, we're going to need to do an iron mine to level 22. Of course, the tavern to level 22, which means that we'll have to upgrade a house. 25 million gold, so not that big a jump. 38 million food, 38 million lumber, so that's a jump of 10 million. I will need to upgrade food storage at least once to accommodate that. 3 million charcoal, that's fine. 76 million marble and 57 million iron. So quite considerable amounts. I've only got 33 million marble, 26 million iron. So it's not horrendous, but it's going to, again, be a couple of weeks. In terms of the upgrade, so this is going to, marble storage 1 will give you the capacity. That's going to give an extra 20 million. So let's actually do that now. This will give me the third rewards chest as well. It's 2 days. Clash of Province rewards, just doing this to get the speed up. So I've hit 4th chest on the daily already. Oh, and I've actually hit 3rd rewards chest on this hour as well. So I'm not going to, I'm not going to upgrade that building right now. Oh, I've done some finding Nian as well. Won't get that finished, unfortunately, because I didn't unlock any boxes yesterday. I just made a mistake with that. So I won't be getting a Nian in this account, but I've got it in quite a few other accounts. What buildings do we unlock as well? Of course, we're going to get the obligatory farm. We'll just pop it there because they do actually go in that section. We get another distillery. So that's going to increase our ale generation. I can take the bountiful harvest, and no, I won't do that yet. So for any of you that are farmers, if you're doing bountiful harvest, a trick that you can do, obviously it's going to give you however many many's worth of resources that you're generating. So with the charcoal, you want to put a little bit of lumber in your factories, fill all of your factories, and then it will, even if you just do a small amount, it will then give you a larger amount of charcoal in that reward. Just a quick tip there. Back onto building. So we've got another lumber yard, a seventh lumber yard. That's really good because we do need a lot of lumber. So I'll be upgrading that building later after I've finished this video. We're getting another charcoal factory as well. So you don't get your eighth charcoal factory, I think, until level until C25. We also get our fifth and sixth crystal workshops. And that's good because crystal workshops only require gold and food to upgrade them. So they're a really nice option to have on your building days if you are trying to get easy points without spending a lot on your key resources. If you look at my food, I'm actually got nearly 100 million food in this account already. So just having that option is really good. Not build, it's going to be military. And we've got another medical tent. And I've just realized I put an encampment in with the medical tents. Let's swap that around. There we go. Okay, so that is all of the buildings that we've unlocked at C22. So for the upgrade requirements, we need to make a house a level 22. So that's going to be 1.1 million gold, 5.7 million food, 1.9 million marble. That's not too bad. Obviously, I try and upgrade all of the houses each level because you're going to need population to upgrade at level at C25. You need 350,000 population. So it's good practice to upgrade your houses. They mainly need food as their primary resource requirement for the upgrade. So that I would suggest that. For the tavern, we're going to need the house at level 22, 11 million gold, 11 million food, 18 million marble. So that's quite a lot of marble again. And if we want to get that storage close to the requirement for iron, we're going to need at least this requirement and then another one as well. So you're going to want to get your iron storage up to level 4. I'll have to check in when I do my weekly update. I'm going to be doing this upgrade this week and then I'll update you again on what the requirement will be for the next level. And food as well is another one that we need to upgrade. We only need to do one food level upgrade and that's going to cost us 7 million gold, 7.2 million marble and 13 million iron. That will then get us above the capacity required for the next upgrade. And as I've already said, my lumber is already there. So those are the key upgrades we're going to need to do. The other one is the iron mine. Again, iron mines are pretty good. Mine are already at level 20, so I only need to do two upgrades on this. And iron mines, it costs you gold, mainly food again. So it's 3 million food for a level 21 upgrade and 540,000 charcoal. So that's a pretty easy upgrade to do. In fact, I might as well just get that started right now. So we'll get some iron mines upgraded today as well. And just to have a look at our nice C22 castle. So there we go. The C22 castle has got the lower roof sections all gold and just a slightly bigger castle. So that's nice. So we're going to be, we are closing in on Pond Farm 6 and 7, which are C23s, even though they are close to their C24 upgrade. So C23 is the next goal. I'm hopeful again that we'll be able to do this in 2 weeks based on the number of requirements and how I'm generating resources in the account. As I say, switching to Raider, I'll be able to get some more gold and increase the amount that I can raid from my farms. Of course, for those of you that are just doing it with normal accounts, and I'm in a privileged position, I'm an experienced player, I've got all of my farms done, and I've got basically unlimited resources that I can raid for this account to upgrade it. So, but for those of you out, you know, just with your main accounts, hopefully you do have maybe one, two, or three farms, or if you've got the time, even more than that, so that you can raid them and get the resources that you need. If not, then obviously you're going to have to go out and make sure you're raiding maybe opponents. If you have an app in your state, you'll have to go after maybe other smaller castles, or if you've got a full non-attacked non-attack in your state, then maybe you want to just, or non-aggression, sorry, then maybe you do just have to focus on getting resources at the weekends on the kill events and do a KE on both Saturday and Sunday. That might be an option for you as well. But of course, when you're raiding, there's always the danger that you can get hit yourself at the weekend. So just something to think about. There we go, guys. That is everything for this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you're enjoying the road to C25. I'd be interested to hear your comments about how your accounts are progressing, or if you're doing anything differently to how I've been upgrading my account here. And of course, if you haven't already, then please do click on that subscribe and ring the bell so you can get notifications whenever I'm dropping videos on the channel. And if you could please share my channel in your Alliance chat, Province chat, and through Line, WhatsApp, Viber, Discord, whatever you use to communicate with your fellow players in the game, that would be much appreciated. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.